Laura Ingraham is a conservative radio talk show host and Fox News contributor. Her latest book, by the way, is called Of the I Zing. We'll get to that in a second. Laura, nice to have you back.
Nice to see you.
This seems like this case over the debt ceiling of the immovable force and the unstoppable, immovable object and the unstoppable force. When it comes to taxes, this issue of revenues, is there any way this deal gets done without the Republicans compromising somewhat on taxes?
Well, I certainly hope they don't compromise on taxes, because the one thing we do know, Matt, when we look at this whole landscape, if the Republicans hadn't taken the House of Representatives last November, if the Tea Party hadn't kind of risen up and gotten all this populist influence, we wouldn't even be having a discussion on any spending cuts. The Democrats would have already voted to increase the debt ceiling. Spending cuts would not even be part of the equation. The only reason we're talking about shrinking the size of government, beyond all these other details, is because the Republicans are listening to the people out there in this country, and you're angry. I mean, these people are angry.
President Obama talks about shared sacrifice. Where is the shared sacrifice going to come from on the Republican side?
Is his shared sacrifice the fact that he canceled his Montana vacation last
week? No, he's opening up
weekend.
A lot of entitlement programs, and he's doing things, as he just said, that's going to he's going to take heat from the Democrats.
Even the Associated Press yesterday said the president was dancing around using the words tax increases. The numbers don't add up. Taxing the upper 1 or 2% income earners in this country does not get us to the math. We have to shrink government. Putting more burdens on the people who actually create jobs. Hey, like NBC,
I think everybody agrees that there's got to be some changes
on
that
Washington
side.
When Washington starts sacrificing instead of actually increasing the salaries of individuals within the executive offices of the presidency, when they start sacrificing, we can talk about the real meaning of sacrifice.
Recent Gallup poll said only 20% of Americans think that spending cuts are the only thing that should be on the table when it talks about this. So they're talking about increasing revenues.
Wait,
they're talking about raising taxes on the 1%, on corporations, even the corporate jets, which is only a few hundred million dollars.
That was a scam and that was a lie. The fact that the media allowed him to get away with that for 5 seconds was absurd. But let me just say this. These little nitty-gritty things, the American people watching this today, they can't control, right? We can't. What happens in Washington, Obama's going to come out and you know, do his rhetoric, and Boehner's going to do the same thing. In the end, the two parties have different visions. Growing this economy has not been done, Matt, by the stimulus bill or health care.
And what I'm asking you is, will this deal absolutely not? Will there be no compromise on taxes on the Republican side, in your opinion?
Will there be compromise on the other side on the issue of freeing up business to create jobs? That's where we are. That's the divide.
This is going to be, all of this will be remembered in 2012 in the campaign. Which side has the most to lose if this deal goes south?
Who has been the adult in the room? Obama comes out, we got to eat our peas yesterday. Oh, excuse me, isn't it your budget that was voted down 97-0 by your own party? We know exactly what he wants to do with our economy.
So you think the Democrats will take the hit on this?
We saw it with stimulus. The Democrats are in big trouble.
Let's